we've got to find ways to get fathers and men back into the home. 64% of every African-American home has the absence of a father. And I think that's showing up in every segment of our society. We need fathers, we need men, we need big brother programs, and certainly a White House counsel to help foster and lead that. Certainly there's value in that. But I think we've got to start right where we are. Certainly can't wait for those resources and those things to take place. And again, I think it starts in the community. I think we need to have, again, big brother programs, big sister programs being encouraged. Faith community must get involved to help men get back in their place. That's really the major contributor. Economically, that's part of the problem. Most families that have a single mother there, economically, they're devastated by the fact that the father is absent. And so we've got to address that because it feeds into every part of our society and our community. So yes, I would support anything you can do to help communicate that and support that.
I would support that as well. And I think fathers and men are extremely important in the lives of their children. In my past life, I did some work for the Council of Children here in Charlotte, and they have another name now. And he sponsored a community-wide fatherhood initiative about 10 years ago. So I clearly understand the importance of fathers in the lives of their children. I was a charter member of the Black Men in Charlotte, founding member, addressing the needs and concerns of African-American males in the city of Charlotte. I firmly believe in second chance programs for many of our kids that are in trouble. And just simply be a second chance. If you've got a criminal record, you can't get an apartment. Mm-hmm. It's hard to get into a public institution, let alone get a job. Mm-hmm. So I'm a firm believer in the second chance program and voted for every voting record, voted for every initiative in dealing with expungement bills. So I think it's important, and as a congressman, I will be very supportive on working with those initiatives, but I think it's extremely important. And again, my record on those issues speak for themselves.
I was very encouraged a few weeks ago when the president announced his initiative for minority boys taking a look at the issues that face our communities especially. I would support creating a council for men and boys as long as there were some substance to it. I think too many times we see, and it doesn't matter who's in the White House, doesn't matter who's, you know, wherever, we see creation of these councils, we see creations of these symbolic positions, but no policy to follow, no substance to follow it. And so I would support it if it was part of a comprehensive effort to address some of these issues that we're talking about.
I think we should start by talking about what we're doing right by looking down Bayswater Road, where the city and the university have come together to begin the process of revitalizing a corridor. That corridor looked blank and vacant for almost 30 years. Now we put $28 million in the ground in terms of building Mosaic Village, turning a garage into the Arch Factory, putting lights underneath the I-77 bridge, investing in the streetcar that hopefully will run down by Johnson C. Smith University, putting a landscape in place in terms of providing for future developments along the West Gray Street corridor, expanding the boundaries of Uptown Charlotte. I think we're doing that right. I think we're doing the right thing by fighting voting suppression laws. I think that's right to do, because we should not have artificial barriers in front of people so they can vote. So protecting and fighting for our rights to vote is the right thing to do. And I think the promise of America is the right thing. I think we live in a country where charity and welfare should no longer be needed. That if you're sick and you need medical attention, you should be able to get it. That if you're hungry, you should be able to get fed. That if you're able-bodied, you should be able to get a job, a good-paying job. Not a job just paying a minimum wage, but a living wage. And good schools should be provided for all. We are doing all those things right. Need some more help, but we're doing them right.
I think we're doing a lot of things right. Part of what we're seeing we're doing right is just our gathering here on Tuesday morning. I'm a Republican sitting between two great Democrats here, and we're enjoying ourselves. The dialogue is right. I can discuss and examine the issues with these men, and we can agree on many, and we can still get along and shake hands, and that's doing it right. I think we are seeing our young people being engaged in the process, getting involved, taking interest in their own community. I think we're doing some things right because we're all beginning to take a part. I think until we continue to move that, we've got to keep that path that we're on. Keep getting involved and keep taking our responsibility as Americans. Because the outcome of our nation is in our hands. I think we've been given a sacred trust. I believe our foreparents and the ones that came before us, all of us have stood on the shoulders of someone. We didn't get here by ourselves. None of us have. And we have a responsibility. And I think we need to take that very seriously, that we take the responsibility of what's been entrusted to us and keep it moving forward. We're doing that right to some degree. We're moving it forward. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Green, for your question. I think there's a lot that is right with this country. Dr. Threatt and I were talking about it outside along the campaign trail. The thing I've been heartened most to see is that there are most Americans out there who care about their country, want to move it forward, are hardworking, want to have big dreams for their families, and are working hard. I think another thing that's right is we can look right to our third row here, third and fourth row, with our students here, a new voter, a new future. They're working hard, they're doing well in school. And then working in the school district every day, I know CMS is much maligned across the community, but being able to work shoulder to shoulder with educators who could be doing other things, but in spite of what they're getting from Raleigh and have been getting from Raleigh, in spite of what they're getting from Washington, D.C., still come in there every day and give their students their best. So I think there's a lot right with this country. And in fact, I don't think that there's anything wrong with this country that can't be fixed with those things that are right. I think we have plenty of goodwill. I think we have people, you know, who are Republicans and Democrats who don't reflect the polarization that we see in Washington, right here in Charlotte, Greensboro, and Winston-Salem. And I'm very encouraged by what I see.
I'm a husband, father, senator, employee, and a congressional candidate for Congress. So I come before you asking for your help. Got a lot of balls in the air. Not perfect by any stretch of the imagination. Pointed that out. I work for a living. But I also work to build a better community. No doubt about it. And I stand on my record, and I don't run away from it. And the resume is important. It's not a professional resume. It's a community investment resume. I put seeds in the ground to build a better community and make sacrifices along the way. And I make no apologies for it. I want the Congress to be your voice and your vote to help make sure that if you need a job, you can get a job. That if you need health care will be provided. Not to run away from the issue of education, making the hard decisions that need to be made. And I believe that the citizens of Winston and Greensboro and High Point and Salisbury and Charlotte all moved in the same direction, we can begin building a better nation right here in the 12th Congressional District. Right. I'm happy to have the support of Harvey Gant, the mayor of Winston-Salem, Kelly Alexander, and a number of other community leaders for this job. My name is Malcolm Graham, and I'm running for the United States Congress. Thank you for listening to me. Thank you very much.
I'm Leon Threatt, and I'm also running for U.S. Congress. I'm committed to the change that we need in America. I think what we've been doing hasn't worked. There comes a time that all of us have to make hard decisions. Or will we sit back and let what we've seen continue? Or will we get involved and bring all that we have to make a positive? I'm not a politician, I'm a citizen who finds himself frustrated about the direction and the concern of our nation. Recently published a book called Storm Warnings. Go to it. Go to Lulu.com and look at this book. I wrote a book because I was concerned about where we were going as a nation. Storm Warnings. I believe if we don't make changes in America, the America that we love and have dreamed to have in our future, our children will not have. I believe we've got to make some changes and make them quick. Politics is normal, as usual, no longer acceptable. I believe we should take personal responsibility for our choices, for our family, for our community, and get all the help we can. It was said that government's role is to do what we ourselves can't do. I think we can do a lot. I have a lot of confidence. The American people have a lot of confidence in each of you. Thank you.
want to thank again Tuesday Morning Forum, thank West Charlotte Recreation Center for having us here today. And you've heard a lot today from each of us, and I thank my opponents for being here today. You know, my quarrel is not with Senator Graham. My quarrel is not with Representative Adams or anybody else in this race. My quarrel is with a country that is going in the wrong direction. My quarrel is with a country where my children are on track to be the first generation to do worse than their parents. That's what I want to go to Washington to solve. You know, we need to look at these races. We need to stop playing with this. We need to just stop sending people to other places just because they've been another place a long time or because they have, you know, things that they can list on the resume. I can list things on my community resume as well. Been here for 40 years. Don't know anything but this community. But what I offer is substantive knowledge in two of the areas that are vexing our country most: healthcare, education. We put people in a lot of seats for reasons unrelated to the job. And then we're surprised when they go there and don't do that job. I ask for your vote. I ask for you to go to my website, Battle for Congress. Thank you very much for the opportunity.